fees or holders?
Is it cosine of three?
I agree with the three.
Then angle third, I don't see.
That's in.
So cosine's related by sine by what?
What?
90 degrees. How is sine and cosine related?
90
degrees phase shift, right?
Yeah.
So really, what I'm looking at would be pi over 6 plus pi over 2, because this is how I go from cosine
to sine.
To sine. Which would be 3 pi over 2 at the end of the day. I'm sorry, 2 pi over 3. How'd you let me get away with that?
Sorry.
Just taking it easy on you, you know? You've had a long day.
That's true.
So there's really not much to it. It's kind of by inspection. If you see a cosine, add 90 degrees to get the phase shifted into the correct element. That's all. The book goes into a lot more like, oh, you gotta do this. Like, guys, just add 90 degrees, you're good to go. Or add pi over 2. Okay. So make sure you can do complex addition and subtraction on the calculator. There are examples in the book. Learn your calculator, do the examples in your book with your calculator so you know how to do it. I'm going to say it again, and I'm going to say it again often. Know your calculator. It will save your butt. Did I say know your calculator?
Can you say it one more time for the video?
Know your calculator.
Thank
just
you.
In case you want to say, know your calculator. That's a good ringtone. Know your calculator. All right. So far, that's kind of like, oh, that's nice, right? That's kind of an academic, but so what? So let's talk about phasors. And the more interesting part of circuit elements. Because really, that's what we're talking about. Right? We did the lab today, we did the lab on Tuesday, we had circuit elements. So in a resistor, if I have V of t, little v, was equal to sine omega t plus phi, the resistor, let's say it this way, I would be what? I of t would be
cosine. No.
It's equal to V over R, right?
Yeah.
V of t over R. So V of t sine omega t plus V over R. Or this could simply be my phasor, so that I of t would be nothing more than my phasor over R. Or very easily, my phasor is nothing more than my resistance times my I version of my phasor. Nothing changes. The resistor is not a time, and in parentheses, I'm going to say frequency dependent device. Right? We turn on power, doesn't matter. Resistor's a resistor. We turn off power, it's gone. There's no energy to discharge from the resistor. There's no resistance that has to charge up to. It simply is on, it simply is off. V equals IR. Right?
Yeah.
But the capacitors and the inductors, Not quite so lucky, are we? See, the resistor only responds to the magnitude of the sinusoid. Nothing to do with the phase, nothing to do with the frequency. On the other hand, for an inductor, V equals what?
V infinite.
You're right.
No.
V infinite.
What is V current? What's an inductor? In an inductor,
Q over I.
D equals L.
Di.
Dt.
Oh.
So if I is equal to some magnitude times sine omega t plus phi, then V is L omega times the magnitude of cosine omega t plus phi, right? Simple differentiation on that one. Which equals L omega Im sine omega t plus phi plus 90 degrees. Or my phasor V is equal to omega L Im with a phase in a phase shift of 90. So voltage leads current in an inductor. Angle's positive. Moreover, V, because we can actually say that this part right here is nothing more than the phasor I, so that V is equal to J omega L times I.
Is that
EJ90? EJ90. So, V is equal to R times I. V is equal to, that's phasor V, is equal to J omega L times phasor I. For the capacitor, I equals what? C?
C.
Do we remember?
DVDT.
DVDT. So using the same exact logic for the inductor, we can say that the I is equal to J omega C V. So phasor I is equal to J omega C phasor V, or